The first one is to tell you that changing your mind isn't just about going from here to here. Sometimes changing your mind is about going from here to here to here. And that's what's happened to me. As I try to think of the most important thing that's happened in these 40 last years to me, I have made up my mind that something I thought was true in the very beginning when the Lutherans refused to ordain me because I was a woman and I had to jump ship. I thought that women were important. In the new slogan, I thought women's lives mattered. And I believed that. But now I believe it 40 times more. I believe it in the marrow of my heart. I believe that women's power is so much larger than what we do with it. So I decided to change my mind and stop believing everything that men tell me. I still listen to them, of course, but I don't really believe everything that they say to me. For example, my great mentor and the pastor who was here at Judson for 35 years before I came, the late great Howard Moody, a man whom I know you know, I love and respect with all my heart and soul. When I had my first grandchild, he wheeled up to me. He was in his chair then. He wheeled up and said, "Donna," that southern accent, "I gotta tell you something. I gotta tell you right now, don't let those kids call you grandma. It'll make you feel old. Suggest another name to them so you don't feel old. Like Boogie." So I took Howard's advice and I said to my grandchildren, all of them and all three, and I said, "Just call me Boogie." And now they call me Boobs, for short. Their own word and their own language. And every one of you who's trying to congratulate me on 40 years of ordination uses the same joke. "Oh, you must have been born when you were 8. I get it. You're trying to not make me feel so old. What I've learned about that old thing is what the great Nick the Raccoon said a long time ago. Wouldn't it be great to be able to look exactly the age that you are and to feel good about it? So if you wanted to say to me, "Oh, you must have been 8 when you were ordained," you could just skip that and say, "Boy, you look 67. You look like a real good 67. I accept that." Another thing Howard Moody said, whenever we had the wonderful services here in the 50s and the 60s and the 70s and the 80s, Howard left in 92, he would say, after all the praying and all the singing and all the amens, he would say, this service ends here, but the real service happens out there. Well, I beg to differ, Reverend Moody. I think that singing and praying, that inner life that allows you to face what's going on out there, is just as important as what happens in the street. I'm not disagreeing or trying to pick a fight with Howard. I'm just